Hello and welcome to the channel. I continue my work with DIY BMS. Today I wanted to explore mounting an external sensor onto the battery, as well as triggering various rules by using relays that are positioned on the main controller board. The way the external sensor is designed is actually an integral part of the board, so it can be snapped off and mounted on the battery. So first, as you can see, it is connected through these tracks. So first of all I need to do is snap it off. Well, it's kind of a bit risky while it's connected, but anyway I'm gonna give it a try. It's not that easy as I thought it would be. Right, you know what, I think I want to disconnect the board. Okay, so board is now disconnected and I'm gonna give it another try. No, I think I'll need to use some tools. Yes, those are definitely vias. So you can see a bit of a copper on inside. And that's basically the reason why it wasn't so easy to take it out. Right, our sensor is now detached. Unfortunately, I have a minor setback. The heat shrink tubing I was hoping to use for this is actually diametrically not large enough for the sensor to be fitted. The good news is the GST connectors I have are good enough to mount it to the board. I think I'm gonna have to isolate it with isolation tape, because although it may not give it the right reading in the temperature, but I'd rather have that than this thing shorting something in the battery and creating a spark, or even worse than that. Okay, so we can mount the sensor somewhere in the battery, and hopefully that will give us right representation of the sensor temperature in one of these cells. So in the meantime, we will need to connect our power cell. Hopefully it still works. Well, at the moment this module is still not recognized. Let's try to see whether if we turn on the power supply. Basically, I measured the voltage on the cell itself, and it is quite low. It's also 1 volt. I suspect that I've just left these cells like this. It's probably discharged itself. So what I'm trying to do now, I'm gonna turn on the charger. It is initialized and it's actually found all the modules. And now a module that was struggling is also now been found and balancing. Now, of course, it was time to try the sensor. So I positioned it over the battery and tried to see how the temperature of this sensor will rise depending on the battery temperature. Unfortunately, the battery remained quite cool, so instead I've decided to remove the sensor and just warm it up in my hand. And you can hopefully see how the temperature of the sensor is coming up, reflecting my body temperature. So let me show you, there are two mechanical ones. So this is one, this is the other one. So there are two solid state relays, which is one of these and one of these. So the solid state relay's output is on this connector labeled RE4 and RE3. And mechanical ones is these ones, RE2 and RE1. So whenever those mechanical relays engaged, we will see LEDs flashing here. Why do we need relays? They're really useful to provide various sort of safety functionality for the BMS. For example, if you're overcharging the modules, you can say when cell is over voltage, you can, let's say, switch off the charger or switch off the contact of high voltage. things like that, or when cell is over temperature. Now let's power BMS and see how we can trigger the relays. Okay, so we're now running DIY BMS. We have all the modules detected. I turned off the charger for a little while because one of the things that I have, this cell is grossly unbalanced, and when charger starts charging, it very quickly does reach the 4.1 volts, the threshold at which the balancing starts, and it starts to overheat. So the rules priority starts from the top and goes to the bottom, and these are the four relays that are available here. Column 1 is relay 1, relay 2, relay 3, and etc. So 1 and 2 would be mechanical relays, and 3 and 4 would be solid state. So I think what I will try to do is I will select, for example, module over temperature functionality, and in this case, for example, over temperature goes to 60. So if I set up relay number 1 to on when this goes over 60, and if I try to do this 30, and for example external over temperature, I set up relay number 2 to on, so then in this case I can warm up external temperature with my hand and use that to trigger it. And also at the same time I can, for example, select solid state to go on when internal temperature reaches the required value. And I'm gonna use relay type standard. There's option standard and pulse, so I'm just gonna go for standard. So save rules. So rules are saved, and now I'm just gonna turn on the charging, and charging is on now. And if we go back to home, you will see that this module number 2, which is not third module in this case, very soon is going to reach 4.1 volts. So it's 4.01. you see now it's reached 4.1 volts, and it's gonna start balancing. So if I now point to this module, so you see this is the module that has red LED on, so it's balancing. When red LED is flashing into balance, now you can see the first relay has gone off and the contact has been made. So this is because the temperature reached 60 degrees and now it's gone back to 58, and it again switched on the relays. Yeah, it's gonna, I think this one is gonna go closed circuit once the LED's gone. Now let's have a look at the solid state relays. So for the rules, what did we set up? For the rules, they should be both on when it reaches 60 degrees. So I presume because that first one is on, those two should be on as well. Yep, that's for sure. So it's on. And this one is on. Okay, and now we're gonna try to look at this other relay. The other relay has a rule set up for cell temperature above 30. So if I now hold my hand over our external temperature sensor, we hopefully will have this second relay should come on. Yep, you can see it has come on. Now if I release my hand, it's hopefully gonna cool down. So now we see this 32 when it goes below 30. 29, yeah, and we can see the relay has gone off and this relay remains on. So I turned off the charging. Hopefully this voltage will drop and temperature will drop. As a result, this relay should be turned off, as well as the solid state relays. So solid state relays. Yeah, you can see that I put my DVM to signal short circuit, and yeah, this is the, yep, so now we can see the temperature reached 57 and relay has turned off. Fantastic. So that's really, really great to have this sort of flexibility with relays. And I think I can program the modules and the rules, so you can have all sorts of safety functionality built in. I think this functionality works really well. And now I can move on to the next milestone.